वित्त मंत्री निर्मला सीतारमण प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस कर रही हैं, वन नेशन वन मार्केट पर आज वो जानकारी देने के लिए जा रही हैं। जो 20 लाख करोड़ का पैकेज है उस पर आज तीसरे दिन लगातार जानकारी दे रही हैं।
आत्मनिर्भर भारत हैड स्पोकन अबाउट सप्लाई चेन रिफॉर्म्स एंड हाउ टेक्नोलॉजी ड्रिवन सिस्टम शुड वर्क एंड ऑल्सो हाउ द डेमोग्राफी विल हैव टू बेनिफिट फ्रॉम इट। सो डिराइविंग फ्रॉम ऑल दिस today, the third tranche of announcements which are being made is focusing on agriculture and allied activities, agriculture, fisheries, dairy, animal husbandry, and allied activities. So, which will also have some aspects of food processing and so on. See, the largest proportion of Indian population is dependent on agriculture even now. And of all those who are dependent on agriculture, nearly 85% of the operational holdings are held by small and medium-sized farmers, small and actually marginal farmers. That is also referred to in the Economic Survey of 2020. However, it always goes to the credit of the Indian farmers who, against all adversities, be it of the monsoon or sometimes unwanted drought or, you know, some crop pestilence, in spite of all that, Indian farmer has always stood up to the challenge, endured a lot, and made India reach certain global benchmarks. Very quickly, I'll tell you, you are aware that India is the largest milk producer, largest jute producer, largest pulses producer, dals, variety of dals. It's also the second largest in global numbers, second largest in the production of sugarcane, in the production of cotton, groundnut, fruits, vegetables, and also in fisheries. India is also third globally placed in the production of cereals. So really, Indian farmers have really endured but made sure that his holdings may be small, but he would give us the highest yield. So today, we want to show you some of the slides also. Very quickly, without spending much time, I'll tell you what kind of support systems that we had established during the lockdown period. So that, as you are aware, keeping all the respects for social distancing and also ensuring all kinds of preventive measures are taken during the lockdown, it goes to the credit of our workers in the fields, our farmers, the peasants and the marginal farm landholders, that they almost concluded the Rabi crop harvest. And also, many of the states have been successful in somehow pushing ahead with due procurement process. The crops have been largely procured in the wheat and the rice growing areas. The process is ongoing, but it goes to the credit of our rural population. So today, therefore, I'll also be showing you a slide a bit later on what we have done in the last 2 months to make sure that agriculture work was supported during the lockdown, just the 2 month story. But otherwise, post that, I'd like to highlight what are we announcing today for supporting agriculture and allied activities. I'll be announcing 11 measures. And from among them, 8 of them relate to strengthening infrastructures, strengthening capacities, building better logistics, and so on. So 8 of them, 8 of the 11 relate to such things where government allocates money, activities will be undertaken in such a way that very quickly we can ramp up on storage, capacities, logistics, and so on. The rest 3 today of the 11 will pertain to governance and administrative reforms. So that's the picture I'd like to put before you. But before we go to the slides, in Hindi.
Namaskar. आत्मनिर्भर भारत अभियान में माननीय प्रधानमंत्री मोदी जी ने 20 लाख करोड़ का जो पैकेज दिया है उसके ही आज तीसरे दिन की मीडिया ब्रीफिंग में हम आपके सामने उपस्थित हैं और आज कृषि के ऊपर ज़्यादा बात करेंगे। कृषि अगर किसान केंद्रित नहीं होगी, किसान कल्याण के लिए नहीं होगी, तो मुझे लगता है अधूरा रह जाता है। शायद यही कारण है कि प्रधानमंत्री मोदी जी ने इसका नाम भी कृषि किसान कल्याण मंत्रालय जैसे रखा था। तो किसानों के कल्याण के लिए लगातार पिछले 5-6 वर्षों में कदम उठाए गए, चाहे वो पीएम किसान योजना है कि साल में 6,000 रुपया किसानों के खाते में सीधा जाएगा, करोड़ों किसानों का आज सीधा उसका लाभ मिलता है। प्रधानमंत्री फसल बीमा योजना, बाढ़ सूखे के समय उनको भरपाई होना, सॉयल हेल्थ कार्ड बनाकर उनकी जमीन के बारे में बताना, ये बहुत सारे कदम पूर्व में उठाए गए। और पिछले कल भी जब हमने प्रवासी मजदूर उनकी समस्याओं को लेकर बहुत सारे मोदी सरकार की ओर से उनके लिए कदम उठाए, तो उसमें दो बातें हमने फार्मर्स के लिए भी किसानों के लिए भी कही थी और उसमें 30,000 करोड़ रुपये की जो अतिरिक्त एमरजेंसी वर्किंग कैपिटल कार्यशील पूंजी की हमने बात कही, ये 90,000 करोड़ के अलावा थी जो किसानों के लिए नबार्ड के माध्यम से लगभग 3 करोड़ परिवारों को इसका लाभ मिलेगा और 2,00,000 क्रेडिट कार्ड बनाकर उनको लगभग 2,00,000 करोड़ का जो हमने लाभ देना था 2,50,000 करोड़ किसानों को, उसकी विशेष मुहिम चलाई जाएगी। ये पिछले कलम आपने आपके सामने रखा था, आज कुछ और कदम उस दिशा में हम उठाने वाले हैं जिसके 11 बिंदु होंगे, उसकी जानकारी अब हम आपको देंगे।
About yesterday's announcement, I think the slide has got enough to give you. I'll straight go over to covering today's announcements. But linkage with the two steps that I had announced yesterday for the agriculture, for the farmers' welfare, for the additional emergency working capital requirements through NABARD, which we would be infusing, and also to make sure that 2,00,000 crore credit will be available under the Kisan credit card. Those were particular references to yesterday. Now we move over to today's, where we are coming up with, before I go to that, in the last 2 months, very quickly, a number of measures have been taken to support farmers, particularly additional steps that we had taken where the minimum support price purchases to an extent of 74,300 crores had taken place during the lockdown. 74,300 crores of purchases based on minimum support price happened during the lockdown, and also 18,700 crores have been transferred to the accounts of farmers directly into their accounts under the scheme PM Kisan Samman. And that is only during the 2 months. And then Fasal Bima Yojana, claim payments have been cleared to the extent of 6,400 crores in the last 2 months. Bima Yojana claims, when a farmer wants to utilize and ask for the claim so that he gets the insurance money in his name, such claims totaling 6,400 crores have been cleared in the last 2 months. We now move to the steps that I want to announce today. There's an additional steps also for the animal husbandry, which is worth recalling. Sorry about this. It's absolutely important to know that during the lockdown, all of you all would have been reporting also media that milk was being produced and the usual restaurants and the hotels and the consumers were all under lockdown. So a lot of dairy industry people were put to severe difficulties. The milk was being thrown on streets saying our consumers are all locked down, they can't buy it from us. So during that period, 560 lakh per day of liters of milk, 560 lakh liters of milk were procured by cooperatives against the daily sale of 360 lakh liters which is produced per day. Now those were also utilized for a further amount of 111 crore liters have also been extra procured over and above the usual quantities which come to the market. 4,100 crores have been paid on that account. So money goes to the hands of the milk producing farmers or dairy keepers. A new scheme also was utilized for interest subvention of about 2% per annum for dairy cooperatives. Additionally, 2% per annum of interest subvention also was provided to incentivize prompt payment, repayment and interest servicing. So, and this scheme is further to be continued, and this is expected to unlock 5,000 crores of additional liquidity benefiting 2 crore farmers. So this is something which was triggered during the lockdown so that farmers get the money in their hands. This is the impact which I'd like to draw your attention to.
कोविड 19 के दौरान पिछले दो महीनों में बहुत सारे कदम किसानों के हित में उठाए गए और न्यूनतम समर्थन मूल्य देने के लिए लगभग 74,300 करोड़ रुपया खर्च किया गया जो सीधा किसानों को गया है उनकी खरीद करने के लिए उत्पाद की। और इसके अलावा जो पीएम किसान योजना है उसके अंतर्गत 18,700 करोड़ रुपया पिछले दो महीनों में किसानों के खाते में सीधा डाला गया है। फसल बीमा योजना के माध्यम से भी जो उनके क्लेम्स मिलने थे वो 6,400 करोड़ रुपये के क्लेम किसानों को मिले हैं। और यही नहीं, पशुपालन एक बहुत महत्वपूर्ण हिस्सा है किसान की ज़िंदगी का, एक अतिरिक्त आय का साधन बनने के लिए, लेकिन दूध की खपत कम हुई और कुल 360 लाख लीटर दूध जो प्रतिदिन पहले वो खरीदते थे उसकी बजाय 560 लाख लीटर प्रतिदिन उन्होंने दूध खरीदा है, जिसके चलते कुल मिलाकर 5,000 करोड़ रुपये की एडिशनल लिक्विडिटी की जो मदद है वो 2 करोड़ किसानों को इस योजना के माध्यम से की गई। और कुल मिलाकर 2% जो है वो ब्याज अनुदान उनको दिया गया, और जिन्होंने जल्द पेमेंट की, प्रॉम्प्ट पेमेंट की है या इंटरेस्ट सर्विस समय पर किया है उनको अतिरिक्त ब्याज अनुदान 2% और दिया गया है। तो कुल मिलाकर 2 करोड़ किसानों को 5,000 करोड़ रुपये का लाभ इसमें हुआ, उनको भुगतान हुआ है, और कुल मिलाकर 111 करोड़ लीटर एक्स्ट्रा प्रोक्योरमेंट इसमें हुई जो लगभग 4100 करोड़ रुपये की है।
Again, for the last 2 months, just to give you reassurance that some of the dates which we had extended for fisheries related activities, because many of them had overseas contracts in getting the brood stock or in getting some of the consignments which were coming from abroad.
फिर से आपको वित्त मंत्री निर्मला सीतारमण की प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस में लिए चलते हैं।
42 नई श्रिम्प हैचरीज को रजिस्ट्रेशन दी गई और जो रेयरिंग हैचरीज जिनकी एक्सपायरी 31 मार्च को हो रही थी उसको 3 महीने की एक्सटेंशन दे दी गई है। और बाकी ऑपरेशंस भी मरीन कैप्चरिंग के लिए जो थे उनको और एक्वाकल्चर के लिए जो रिलैक्सेशन देनी थी वो भी दी गई, और जो 4 घोषणाएं हमने इनको लेकर पहले की थी उनको भी लागू कर दिया गया है मत्स्य पालन को लेकर।
आई गो टू टुडेज अनाउंसमेंट्स। The third tranche covering agriculture. First eight steps are towards money is going for infrastructure capacity building. And from among the 8, so the first one is we provide 1 lakh crore for aggregators, FPOs, primary agriculture cooperative societies, farmer producer organizations which are mentioned, FPOs, all for strengthening the farm gate infrastructure. Farm gate infrastructure are cold chains, post-harvest management infrastructure, storage centers, yards from where they have to do it. So this fund for 1 lakh crore is being created. Here private entrepreneurs, agricultural entrepreneurs, startups, all of whom are now looking at facilitating by procuring from the farmers and reaching out with value addition to the global markets, don't have the infrastructure. So this fund for 1 lakh crore will immediately address that issue, and that fund will be created at the earliest.
हमारा किसान बाढ़ हो, बारिश हो, तूफान हो, आंधी हो, अपना पसीना बहाकर 137 करोड़ भारतीयों का पेट तो भरता ही है, लेकिन उसके साथ साथ एक्सपोर्ट करने में मदद करता है, लेकिन भंडारण की कमियां होने के कारण कई बार और मूल्य संवर्धन के अवसर ना होने के कारण कमी रह जाती थी। उस कमी को पूरा करने के लिए 1,00,000 करोड़ रुपये का कृषि आधारभूत ढांचा बनाने के लिए ये योजना लाई गई है, जिसमें चाहे कोल्ड चेन हो या फसल कटाई के बाद प्रबंधन करने के लिए जो भी सुविधाएं वैल्यू चेन के लिए बनानी हो वो उसमें बनाई जाएंगी, और इससे लाभ मिलेगा मूल्य संवर्धन के लिए भी, भंडारण की क्षमता बढ़ाने के लिए भी, और कुल मिलाकर किसान की आय को भी इसमें बढ़ोतरी मिलेगी, और भारत न केवल अपनी मांग को पूरी कर पाएगा, एक्सपोर्ट करने में भी इसकी आने वाले समय में बहुत मदद मिलेगी। और ये जो है इसका जो लाभ होगा वो प्राइमरी एग्रीकल्चर कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज हो, फार्मर प्रोड्यूस ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस हो जो किसान उत्पादक संघ हैं, या कृषि उद्यमी हो, स्टार्टअप्स हो, एग्रीगेटर्स हो जो इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर कृषि के क्षेत्र में लाते हैं, ये सब इनके माध्यम से आधारभूत ढांचा कृषि के क्षेत्र में उनके फार्म गेट पर खड़ा किया जाएगा, ताकि इन सुविधाओं का लाभ मिल सके और इस फंड को जल्दी क्रिएट करके शुरुआत की जाएगी।
द नेक्स्ट ऑफ द 8 स्टेप्स टुवर्ड्स कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग, लॉजिस्टिक्स एंड सो ऑन इज फॉर फूड एंटरप्राइजेस हु आर माइक्रो इन साइज। वी शैल बी प्रोवाइडिंग अ फंड ऑफ 10,000 crores. It's a scheme which will get executed with a cluster-based approach. I recall Prime Minister Modi when he spoke on the 12th of May, speaking about be vocal for local. This is one of the ways in which the local capacities, the local value-added product can have a global outreach, can reach out for global markets. And build brands, they can create products of global standards, and therefore marketing them globally will also be assisted through this fund. Most of the products that we are aiming to deal with in this scheme will be related to health and wellness products, nutritional products, herbal products, organic products, and products which are now being used as alternatives for a healthy living. So this we expect will benefit 2 lakh MFEs, micro food enterprises. 2 lakh of them will benefit by bringing them up to that level, modernizing their production techniques, giving them capacities, branding their produce and so on. But because it's going to be cluster based, I would want to broadly give you a picture of what we are aiming at. Let us say if it is Bihar, makhana is considered to be one of the very nutritious food without any calorie concerns. One can always use it as a snack. And therefore in Bihar, the cluster would aim at makhana cluster. Kashmir would aim at kesar, saffron cluster. Karnataka can have ragi and coarse grains, which is today considered to be the most healthiest alternative to for gluten-rich wheat and rice. So the northeast will have bamboo shoots and organic fruits. Telangana can have turmeric. We are only suggesting this because turmeric latte is a big thing outside, milk made out of whipping cream and turmeric. So turmeric is rich in this country. There can be clusters formed. And Andhra can do chilies. Tamil Nadu can do tapioca, sago and whole lot of other things. I'm just giving examples. So the cluster based is going to focus on those organic and herbal materials or nutritional and health conscious wellness related food items in which India has a great strength. So this particular micro fund enterprises, which will have 10,000 crores given by the government, will aim at branding and promoting such clusters. The focus will be on women, focus will be on SC and STs, focus on...
तो हर्बल ऑर्गेनिक और पोषक उत्पादों पर जोर दिया जाएगा, इसके लिए बाकायदा फंडिंग की जाएगी और लोकल के लिए वोकल होना है और लोकल को ही नेशनल बनाना है। तमाम जानकारी दी।